Inside this famous St. Paul landmark, the governor and legislators work to pass laws that affect all the citizens of our state. When Minnesotans see the Capitol Dome, they think of St. Paul and state government. But this dome would not be here, and it would be a very different city today if a man named Joe Rolette had not done something very bold and unexpected back in 1857. In 1849, St. Paul was named the territorial capital of Minnesota, though not without disagreement. Some wanted the capital to be at St. Anthony, present-day Minneapolis. Others chose Mendota, on the hill called Pilot Knob, across the river from Fort Snelling. This location would offer a sweeping view of both the Mississippi and St. Peter's rivers. The St. Peter's River would later be named the Minnesota River. But the St. Paul supporters prevailed, and as the new capital, the town continued to grow. Steamboats brought more settlers here, to what was then the northwestern frontier of our nation. Still, not everyone was satisfied. In 1857, the territorial legislature passed a bill to move the capital 70 miles southwest up the river to the town of St. Peter. Only the governor's signature was needed, and St. Paul would be the capital city no more. It was at this point that Joe Rolette made his mark on local history. Rolette was the popular and good-humored representative from Pembina, a town on the Canadian border in present-day North Dakota. The son of a French-Canadian fur trader, Rolette was well-liked and a bit eccentric, such as his habit of wearing Indian clothing at home. As chairman of the enrollment committee, it was his responsibility to forward any legislation to the governor's office for a signature. On this occasion, for reasons we may never know, Joe Rolette left the Capitol chambers with a bill in his hand, but instead of delivering it to the governor, he walked out of the building and back to his hotel in Lower Town. There, he locked the bill in a bank vault and vanished from view. Meanwhile, the legislature continued its session and waited for Rolette to return. They could not adjourn until the matter was resolved. The hours dragged on and men were sent to find him. Sightings of Rolette heading up north on his dog sled could not be confirmed. Although he had apparently checked out of the hotel, many who knew him were convinced that he was still there, hiding out, playing cards, and having a laugh at their expense. It turns out they were right. The legislators were forced to live in the chambers for 5 straight days, waiting. Just after the deadline for passing the bill had ended, Joe Rolette burst through the doors as the punchline to his own practical joke. Not everyone was amused, especially the town of St. Peter, where the construction of some government buildings had taken place in anticipation of the move. The matter was settled once and for all by the Supreme Court. They ruled that since all necessary signatures were not on the bill, no law had been passed, removing the capital from St. Paul to St. Peter. And as they say, the rest is history.